Check I'm not blowing out. Blowing out the recording here. Now. Needs to be that loud. Watching on YouTube, I'm playing the Goya Panther with tape wound flats on. It's a little bit of a finicky bass. I haven't played in a while, as I said, and just figured it would be nice to work on some groove today. What was that? playing this bass. I'm actually going to grab, maybe grab the jazz bass for a second. Just want to try this stuff. A few different scenarios. We're about to find, put tape wounds on the jazz bass. Forgot about that. Maybe the Mustang. Let's find out if this bass even plays. I just wanted to try this stuff on a bass with round wounds on it. Haven't touched this bass in a while either. Let's get this thing tuned up. Where are we at here? Some volume might help. Okay. Oh, these strings feel super dead. Let's find out. That might actually work for the Afrobeat stuff. Okay. Thing was pretty well in tune. Maybe Chelsea's been playing this. Oh, what a different sound. Wow, let's see. So weird, huh? And super thin as well. I want to get a better sound. Also want to make sure I'm not blowing out the recorder here. Yeah, this is going to be a little peaky. Let's try that. Action is so low on this thing, it's crazy. It's just really poorly set up. Actually, the E string is like almost a quarter of an inch lower than any of the other strings on the bass. Bummer. Okay, I kind of want to play a little bit more with it though. String is really, really bugging me, unfortunately. That's a shame. This is a good lesson in taking care of your instruments, which obviously I don't do enough of, and all of these need to go to some sort of instrument doctor and get set up. Let's try something else. Let's grab the Matteson 4 string. Okay, one second. Be right back. Again, for anyone not watching, I have two racks of basses. They are at opposite ends of the studio. hence the walking around and the long silences. Okay. Oh. Even feels better right away, just with my left hand on the bass, because I know it's set up a bit better. Let's see, plug it in. Gwizdala, how on earth do you forget to plug it in after all these years? Okay, let's see if we can get this thing in tune. And go for it. Something a little more punchy with round wounds on it. I can just... Woo! Okay, big boy bass now. I don't even know what strings are on here. The action is definitely up. That's nice. Sound here, maybe try the. Do some palm stuff. Okay, so gotta have the discipline to try and stay with the idea as long as possible. I like doing that. Definitely not set up for slapping. Action on this one is super high. We have a visitor. Hello. I am filming. I'll see you in a minute. Nope. Yeah, sometimes you gotta stop and work it out. Maybe put a little more, a few more highs in there perhaps. Gotta get the pattern the right way. So, kind of a quick one today, I guess. I don't have too much more time, because check this out. This is our little printed proof right here of the Bass Player's Guide to Looping, and this is how it's going to look. We just print these off so we can do a final proofread before it goes to Amazon today to be published in the physical form. You guys have another 3 days, I think that's it, until the midnight on the 28th. of November to pre-order Bass Player's Guide to Looping. There's an automatic 25% discount for anyone who pre-orders the book. You just go to my website, to my e-store. It's right there on the front page. No need for a discount code or anything. It's right now 25% off for all pre-orders. And then the book comes out on Friday. Everyone who pre-ordered will be getting that book Friday. So, quick plug. Podcast brought to you by Bass Player's Guide to Looping. Beast the shit out of hearing about Squarespace or the Cash App. Kind of the unglamorous side of things, right? Working on the real basics. You guys have seen over the past couple of weeks, heard rather, if you're listening on a podcast, kind of the look inside the technique and how that develops, and that's kind of one side of it. This is definitely the other, perhaps even more important side of it that often gets overlooked. It definitely doesn't make it to YouTube and into podcasts like this that often, because I guess people consider it to be somewhat mundane and boring. It's not flashy. It's just, you know, when we're playing his 16th notes. But that freedom to be able to do that anywhere on the instrument and really be in control of where the accents are and the time and the feel and the sound and all of those things, to be able to do that across a bunch of different instruments, different basses. And for it to feel good and feel comfortable and relaxed and feel like you're really in that space, in the flow, you're kind of in the zone to be creating and not being hindered at all. That is the slightly more unglamorous side of things that doesn't often get looked at that much. I just want to remind people how important that is. I know I am preaching to the choir to a lot of people listening to this. I know you guys do a lot of this just as I do, just as everyone does. But for anyone who's listening that wonders kind of where they should place, you know, importance, what they should place importance on, I would say this kind of stuff. And making it fun with like an Afrobeat groove, playing a different bass for a change that I don't play too often. I got a little bit out there. The E string threw me off. It wasn't as clean on the bottom string. Identifying things like that, like you heard, I didn't really nail it the first time. The octave was ironically easier to nail, but this minor sixth, I scuffed up. I was playing the wrong fingering on the right hand. I was trying to go for the whatever. I was just kind of upside down. Right there, did it again. So there are some super fundamental things that I'm not particularly nailing, so it's great to uncover those and just create an exercise out of that. I was doing was making the interval run down chromatically, so octave, major 7, flat 7, 6, flat 6, 5, etc., all the way down, 2, flat 2, 1. On paper, that is a really simple thing, right? In reality, a little bit more challenging. It's where the fingering on the left hand shifts. You gotta be really clean there. Okay. Anyway, that is it for today. Kind of a short one. Nice solid 25 minutes working on some groove things. I have to get to final proofreading of Bass Player's Guide to Looping because it's not all just practicing here. I have to split up my time and make sure things are being taken care of appropriately. And that includes, like, you know, rock and roll stuff like doing laundry and feeding the dog. So, it's all part of it. Cats, thank you so much for sticking around. What are we, 13, I think, of these? I keep, at the end of all of these episodes, I'm like shocked that we're so far into it already, almost 2 weeks into it. But Don't forget, we have the Two Bass Hit podcast, Chelsea, and I have the podcast Two Bass Hit. That's on Instagram at twobass.hit. That is on my channel as well. Chelsea just played at the Hollywood Bowl last night with Kanye West, and the new episode of that podcast is out right now. You go check out the full story and dissection of playing a massive gig with a massive artist in a massive venue. Really, really interesting conversation. We came straight home from the show, got into the studio and turned the mics on and ran it down. So, yeah, that's it for today, for filming anyway. I'll be back practicing later, but we'll see you guys tomorrow.